Hi, I'm Jake, a program manager at DataRobot. Today I'll be talking to you about target leakage. Now, target leakage is a problem because if you use a model that contains leakage, it may look good during the training phase, but it will make wildly inaccurate predictions once you finally get to using it in a production environment. So what is target leakage? It's when you're using information in the data set that you would not have at the time of prediction. Effectively, you're using data from the future in order to try and predict the past. For any Mean Girls fans out there, it's like that scene with Karen, where she's able to predict the weather if she already knows that it's raining. She's using information from the future to then try and predict the past. So let's look at this in a banking environment. We have a bank underwriter whose responsibility is to decide which loans the bank will or will not decide to issue. Each one is going to expose the bank to a certain degree of risk. Now, if the bank underwriter is relying on a model that contains target leakage, a new loan application might show that it has a 20% chance of default according to the model, but the reality is that it's actually far greater at, say, 80% chance of default. This exposes the bank to significantly more risk than the underwriter was expecting, and perhaps than the bank's rules actually allow for. But how did all of this happen? It starts with the curation of the original data set. We want to make sure that we're only using information we'd have at the time of prediction and not anything that occurs later than that. So with this specific example, the data set accidentally contained the latest snapshot of all of our loan customers' FICO scores. This is problematic because we're trying to predict the chance of default at time of application, not say 90 days after the loan has already been issued. So we need to be very, very careful in these situations to ensure that we don't include information from the future when we're trying to predict information that's occurring in the past. In this specific example, if we wanted to, say, predict the chance of a loan's default after 90 days, that most recent snapshot of FICO scores is perfectly acceptable to use because it's information that's occurring at the same exact time as when the predictions are being made. So now that we know a bit more about target leakage, we want to focus on how do we eliminate it. Perhaps the only possible way to do so is to focus on the data set that you're going to use for training when you're creating it. We want to think about each individual variable and really understand the context of if that information is available at the same time that we're making prediction, or if that data only becomes available to us or is known after the time of prediction. In the case of the banker, again, we want to focus on we're making predictions at the time the loan application is received, and therefore we can only use information from that same point in time. We would need FICO scores of all of our bank customers at the time that they made their application, not 9 days after they've already had the loan. If we look at it in the case of a telecommunications provider, we want to look at each one of these variables and understand if it's available to us at the point in time where we're trying to predict if a specific wireless subscriber will churn. So customer ID, the length of time and months that their account has been open, their state of residence, different features about their cell phone plan, and if they're a business or individual subscriber, are all variables and information we would know when we're trying to predict if an individual subscriber is going to churn in the future. Now, the one that should cause some red flags and raise a bit of suspicion is this rep column here. This is the name of the last service rep that any one of these customers spoke to. Now, it may seem innocent enough on the surface. However, for this specific wireless communications company, they route all of their retention calls through one department. Therefore, there are a finite number of names that could appear as the last representative an individual customer spoke to. In this case, Rose and Taylor both work in the retention department, and therefore they're commonly associated and they're appearing here next to customers who ended up churning. This is problematic because the model will start to associate the name Rose and the name Taylor with customers that have a high risk of churning, and it will start to assign lower risk to names like Frank and Renee that didn't result in customers that churned. The problem with this, though, is that we would never know if a customer is going to speak to Rose or Taylor before we know their intent to churn, because we would not route them to the retention department otherwise. So what we want to do is either eliminate this column entirely, or we would want to use this data set for a different type of problem where we do know the last service rep they spoke to at that time of prediction. A great example would be if we want to predict if a previous wireless subscriber who did churn is willing or interested in coming back for our service. So that's target leakage for you today. You should be very careful and mindful to make sure it doesn't find its way into your training data sets. Otherwise, it can cost your company millions in the long run and impact customer satisfaction negatively.
you.